brouhaha.
Dan zit je brouhaha.
Dan zit je brouhaha.
Dan zit je brouhaha.
Dan zit je brouhaha. Qu'est-ce que c'est le brouhaha?
Ah, qu'est-ce que c'est le brouhaha? In a nutshell, the brouhaha is me talking and inviting friends to join me every single day and talk about things and stuff. So the lineup of who you're going to hear from one day to the next on the morning brouhaha is always different. Typically, Eric joins us. Guess what? Eric joins us. Good morning, Eric Raymond, with your new microphone.
Hello, John Milky. How are you?
I'm okay, I guess.
Yeah, you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay, sure? I guess. Yeah.
Okay.
Tired of winter. I'm tired of hearing things like Lowell Green yesterday talking about the fact that, you know, with the way things are as far as where we are in the big line to get the vaccines, it'll probably be the middle of next year before Canadians actually get vaccinated. That kept me awake all freaking night.
At this point, yeah, it's pretty crazy.
There you go. Dowda is joining us in just a matter of moments. Kathy Jennings will be back tomorrow. But here's the idea for the morning brouhaha. We want to keep it light. We want to keep the conversation relevant, of course. But in a nutshell, if you've got an open mind, we've got an open line for you. We'd love for you to join us and talk about whatever's on your mind today. 613-606-8786 is our phone number. It's our text line, and it's also our Zoom meeting ID. 613-606-8786. Good morning, Dowda. Digi Dowda. That's your new name. Digi Dowda.
He's frozen already.
Right?
Right as soon as he gets in.
Can we just, if you're able, if your internet is connecting properly, can we just celebrate the fact that this is the first time we've taken the morning brouhaha live on Facebook? Yay!
Let's go.
Yeah, so the morning brouhaha. Eric, okay. Hello, Digi Dowda.
Dowda.
Still going to get roasted.
When I get rich and famous, Dowda, I am buying you your very own internet connection. Dial up. Dial up even.
Yeah. It might be better than this one.
Having to live through the years of the dial up internet.
There you go. So yeah, Eric, how long have we been doing the morning brouhaha now? A couple of weeks.
I mean, technically as the brouhaha, probably 2 weeks now. This is probably near the end of
I don't know why I'm asking you this. I should be referring to the number of podcast episodes I've uploaded. I want to say 14. So yeah, 2 weeks. Well, actually, 14 would make it about 3 weeks now, wouldn't it? Because we don't count weekends.
Yeah, we only do five a week. Discover favorites.
It's all good. It's all good. So 2-3 weeks, and finally on Facebook Live, because Facebook would, and ordinarily I would do the show on Facebook, except for the fact that I typically stream music, and Facebook doesn't allow that. So now that we've got a talk component to the show, I thought, why not? I'll spend the $20, and I will add the second, or the third, actually it's the third feed, to my Restream account, and now I can have Lowell do his thing on his page, I can have us do our thing on the Blast of the Radio. Oh, I should go to the Blast of the Radio page and share this. Hang on.
There we go.
Yeah. How do you spell blast? How do you spell blast the radio?
BTR.
I wish I could spell it BTR. Do you know how badly I want to have BTR.com?
There you go.
Except it's Beyond the Rack owns it, and they own the .ca as well, even though they don't have a presence in Canada and they won't release it. It's very upsetting. It's very upsetting. Look at that. We've already reached 10 people. We got 3 people watching on Facebook. Hello, 3 people on Facebook. Oh, 2 people now.
Oh, no, that's somebody already dropped off. Ah, crap.
That's going well. Hey, Dowda, what do you think of Eric's microphone? New microphone. How's it sounding on your end? Stunned silence. That's how it's going.
Yeah,
stunned.
That sounds fine. Sounds like his normal fells.
I was like, he's so stunned that he just can't even speak.
I was like going back and forth like here and talking to a friend, and like because the fact that this a few days ago Andrew Kiff and I were talking about having to do a podcast,
what in the hell was that?
And
yeah,
last night I even asked like what time we're gonna do it for today. And he never really gave me a definitive answer of, like, what time we're actually doing it.
Unfortunately,
So I was like going back and forth, and apparently she said that we would do a podcast.
I could listen to this. This is painful, like, but I could listen to it all day, like, Eric.
Is that oh my the, god! The timing, like,
Dauda.
Digi Dauda.
Dauda.
No, you got to skip every second syllable in that.
Yo, I'm still here.
Kind of, sort of, right? So Neo Kiffmeister said He says, I did.
I did what?
I don't know what he did, but he did. You don't listen, he says, Dauda.
I'm so lost right now, guys.
I know, so am I.
I asked, like, what time? Just, okay. So we're supposed to do like a podcast today. It's just that more like I even asked like what time we're supposed to do the podcast, but I never like we never really agreed upon
the actual time.
Oh, I see. We're taking care of our personal daytimers now on the show, are we? Well, let me see. 2 o'clock this afternoon. what's John got on his agenda today? What is today? Thursday?
Because I know that it's supposed to be like between like 9 and 12, but like I'm just needed like the exact time just so that
still going.
Yeah. Start with the recording.
There you go. Okay, Dauda. So
Dauda's doing a podcast today at some time. That's what we've decided.
Yes, there you go. So Chrissy has an idea. She says we need to start a GoFundMe for Dauda's internet.
Yes,
connection.
We do. Yes, we do. We need to get him at least 56K dial up, I think.
Yeah, at least. Hopefully that will work.
Howard suggests that maybe Dauda needs to start doing the show from a Starbucks or a Tim's where they've got free Wi-Fi.
Even though you can't really go in and sit down.
No, but you can sit. I mean, you can sit outside, right?
Yeah, just go. Like, do you have a car? You go sit in your car, just connect to the Wi-Fi, and do it from your front seat of your car.
Yeah, there you go. Look at us.
Or the back seat.
We're nothing but solutions. Dauda, actually, can we talk about your podcast? Because I meant to talk about this yesterday, because I noticed you were back up on your social media talking about the relaunch of your podcast. So you'd had a podcast for some time. I guess you let it go quiet for months and months and months, and now it's back. What's your podcast about?
Okay, so pretty much when I first started, it was like I've loved having to like talk about some things in my life as well as like with music.
Sure.
Because like, and then when I got to the program, it's like by the time it was the summer, finished my first year, I was like, okay, you know what? I'm actually gonna like having to change up some of the show already because it was made by a former friend of mine. And wasn't doing too well, but mostly because it wasn't consistent in terms of things. So right. I took matters into my own hands and having to at least rebrand it in a way by interviewing just artists from like the Ottawa area that we play on CKDJ at the time at least. And then after that, I ended up like interviewing like artists like Roland Prince, like Trundle, Dre, and of course I mentioned this before, as I even interviewed Tony Danza for like as one of the episodes, which nice. I was actually glad I got to do. And
yeah, that's pretty awesome.
Of course, I even like yeah, that was still one of my highlights. So I ended up having to even do some episodes before I left the country 2 years back, like with the Lionels and with also two of my friends, one from high school, one from my days in co-op. And then ever since then, I made like a pretty good amount of episodes for it. And so then right now I'm still trying to make plans for season two so that I can like get things working again.
All right. You sold me.
There you go.
Eric, is that your computer making that noise? It's a little sing-songy. Bling, bling.
I don't know. What do you mean? Well, bling, bling.
Even though I was only here for like a few minutes, Matt's like...
It's a notification that
even though I've only been here for like a few minutes, Matt's like, get going because...
I mean, I don't know. My computer doesn't really... Yeah, I don't know. That's weird.
Because now that you've got it all hooked up to your new board and stuff, like we've not heard computers singing like that before, and that's a sound I'm not familiar with in my studio.
Oh, well, it's maybe it is.
No, it's not an offensive sound by any stretch of the imagination. I just know every single person who's tuned into this broadcast right now. Every time they hear it, they're looking at their phone, they're looking at their computer, and it's like, who's trying to get a hold of me? What is that? What is that?
I don't know. Maybe.
And Doubt is frozen again. Did Doubt just say he was leaving?
No. Gotta get going. There
gotta
you
get
go.
Going. All right, Doubt. Bye,
Doubt.
Bye, Digi Doubt.
Bye.
Bye. Wow, that was fun.
What are we going to do? I love the guy, but what are we going to do about that internet connection? It's just...
Oh, my God.
I mean, I love... Like, you and I were talking... See, that's got to be you.
That is not... I don't hear it on my end. I hear it coming through on your end.
What is this?
Is that like notifications from Facebook? Because now that you're live on Facebook, it's a weird notification.
Oh, well.
Or live on the streamer. I don't know. Because like I heard it this time, but I didn't hear it through my headphones or my computer. I heard it on your from coming through your screen.
How can you tell the difference?
Because it's not.
Okay,
loud.
It's not.
See, that's on your end.
See, it can't be though. Oh, wait.
Howard Goldenberg is now following. It just popped up on the Twitch stream. So maybe it's every time somebody follows.
So I've turned. So I've got two volume controls on my mixer. One controls my in-studio computer, which I've had silenced. Shut up! What is this?
Is that noise?
Howard Goldenberg has shared. So that's a Twitch notification. Okay, we're on to something. This is a Twitch notification coming in from somewhere.
Because I'm like, it's
not on
my end.
I know what it is. Hang on. So, no, that's not it. What the hell?
Has shared your stream.
What? Oh, yeah, that's the notice. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so anytime somebody donates on Twitch or joins on Twitch...
On Twitch, it goes bling.
Yeah, sends a little zombie guy walking across the screen, and you get this little bling.
Yes.
Okay, so that's what the sound is. But I don't understand. Then it's got to be coming from your computer because I've got two volume controls on my mixer in the studio. One controls my main online computer, which I've had silenced and muted for years.
I mean, my Twitch is muted. So I mean,
so the only other volume I've got up now is you.
Oh, well, that's weird.
Okay, so anything coming in, well, it's you, but it's also whatever's coming in off that computer in my studio.
Huh.
I did have Twitch activated last night. I had the volume up on Twitch last night because we had diversityinthecapital.tv,
right.
And that's how I take their feed, but the volume is now back down.
Oh.
So I
don't know, because, I mean, on my end, the Twitch is like muted on my computer. But.
You know what we need to do, people, in order to figure this out? I need everybody to make a donation of at least $100 today. If you could all just jump on Twitch right now, I need each of you to donate 10,000 bits to test. This is just take one for the team, will you? Help us resolve the issue of where this audio is coming from. Not a single person.
Bueller. Everyone's like, nah, that's Bueller. Okay, man.
Oh,
Bueller.
Hey, can I tell you some great news?
Yes, tell me news.
Yes, it's sports news, Eric. as you know, I kind of jumped on the whole Bills bandwagon with the season progressing the way it was for the Bills. Pretty excited by them and for them. And I don't really have a team in the NFL, so to speak. But the Bills were looking really, really good, and sort of at the last minute, I'd been looking for NFL merchandise, but of course you can't go to, like, a sport check, you can't go to, like, a Clubhouse Sports, you can't go anywhere and buy a damn t-shirt, whatever else. I even had friends who, you know, were brave enough to go into, like, a Walmart or a Giant Tiger, have a little look around, see if they could find any Bills merchandise, with no luck. And then finally at the last minute, Howard had been suggesting go to the NFLshop.ca, and finally at the last minute I went, okay, fine. So I did. And, well, I told the story of I ordered the shirt, And they said 3 to 5 business days for shipping, but you can get free shipping if you add this much to your cart. So, all right, fine. I'll add the hat to my cart. Didn't really want the hat. Still didn't equate to enough for me to be able to get free shipping. Fine. Then the hat arrives.
Yes.
Way ahead of the shirt. The shirt finally arrived like yesterday.
Yes.
Yesterday it finally arrived. So the damn Bills have to do really well again next year, because now I've got a t-shirt sitting here collecting dust until the NFL season kicks off. Howard, no, come on. Holy crap. Howard just made a donation.
I saw that.
Of 10,000. Howard. Okay, Howard, here's the deal. Okay. All right, how do I do this delicately?
Uh-oh.
Today is... It's a day. You know what I'm talking about.
Yep.
There's a big corporation that has its day. It's a big corporation that I used to work for. In a nutshell, I find the whole thing very triggering. And I posted on my Facebook, and this is, I really don't want to tread too deeply into these waters, okay? They are a partner of mine on one business side, okay? And I respect that relationship. But I've said very vocally, I will take it upon myself to donate to a genuine mental health charity today. Howard is always incredibly generous and just donated literally 10,000 bits. That's about $100. Howard, jeez. I'm taking your $100 and I am going to donate that to the Roberts Smart Center. Okay?
Awesome.
Roberts Smart Center is a facility for youth here in the nation's capital who typically invite me to MC their annual golf tournament. Obviously, we weren't able to do that golf tournament this past year. And so thank you, Howard. James says you asked for it. I did ask for it. I was joking. I was kind of joking. I really just, I'm curious. I don't like odd sounds that I can't identify. James, you being an audio tech, you understand this. When you don't know where sounds are coming from in your feed, you kind of freak out and get lost and get caught up on it. I did ask for it. Thank you, Howard. I am absolutely donating that. That's being passed right along to the Roberts Smart Center. So there you go. Thank you, Howard. Thank you very, very much, Howard. Appreciate that very, very much. And apparently we've lost Eric somewhere in the mix.
No, I'm here. I'm still here.
Yeah, guys, don't take me too seriously when it talks about money. But Howard, thank you. That just turned my whole day around, because I find this day very triggering. Incredibly triggering. And I wish I could get into more details, but suffice to say, I had to sign a piece of paper that doesn't allow me to.
Ah, well, there you go.
There you go. Look. Okay. Audience, I need some help.
Yes.
Eric, you know where this is going.
Uh-oh.
Audience, whether you're on Facebook Live, whether you're on Twitch, I need some random words. How many random words do I need depends on this message, though. Hang on a second here. Eric, vamp a little bit.
Vamp? Like, what?
Jazz talk? Hands. Do a little dance. Oh, nice. On hold music. Solicit more donations. Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Okay. I need 3 random words.
Ooh, 3 random words.
I need 3 random words from the audience. So I'm keeping an eye on Twitch. How the hell do I find? Okay. How do I spell blast the radio again? I got 20.
Blast.
There are way too many things to be following on this show now, dude.
22 people on Twitch, 10 and 9 people on Facebook.
3 on Facebook.
I see 9 apparently live on Facebook.
I like whatever you're, whatever you're seeing is infinitely better than what I'm seeing.
Somebody said, Chrissy said Milky Way.
Milky Way. Okay. Milky Way is one word now. So am I. Okay. I need.
Shazam.
Shazam?
James says Shazam.
Okay, and I need a third random word, please.
Third random word. Come on, audience.
See, now I'm seeing 7 on Facebook.
Yeah, I see 7 now.
Oh, there we go. Miss Imagine That is now following us along on Facebook. Hi, Miss Imagine That. Hi. Boy, I had better luck getting $100 out of somebody than I did getting their Tarzan. Okay, all right.
Tarzan, there you go.
All right. So
somebody else, well, and then there's Frosty, there's Whitney, there's Pink, so you could pick any of them.
All right. Well, we've got our three random words. So okay, y'all know about OnlyFans, right? Where you pay to see. So I was curious once upon a time. Of course, I need to put the whole backstory here. I was curious once upon a time, could I put the radio station on OnlyFans? Are there things I could be offering, you know, on a paid tier that would help me earn a living? And the more I looked at OnlyFans, the more I realized that, no, it's not for that at all.
No.
But then I discovered Maitland Ward. Mm-hmm. Who used to be on a TV sitcom called Boy Meets World.
Yep.
Maitland Ward is, she seems like a very nice person.
Yeah.
She seems like a very nice person. So when I first got on OnlyFans, I thought, what is that?
Again. Andrea77WPG subscribed at tier one. Subscribed for 21 months.
Awesome. But where's it coming from? I don't understand. Oh. No, it can't be coming from my phone. I don't have it turned off. Anyway, so yes, Maitland Ward seems like a very nice person, and I thought I would give her a follow as I experimented with OnlyFans, and she had like a $7.99 a month special, and I would get all these lovely messages. They seem so genuine. Maitland Ward just talking to me and only me. I'm sure they weren't like a mass message to all of her followers. No, they were just John.
No, just straight to you, John.
Anyway, I caught on to that kind of quick is what I'm saying. But out of nowhere, I started getting these messages offering a free subscription to Masha Barbie. Masha Barbie. I have no idea who Masha Barbie is. She could be the nicest person on the planet. No idea. But as I articulated yesterday, Barbie appears to have a little bit of plastic. Just saying. You don't have to go searching. Suffice to say, and I don't want to be mean. I don't want to be, you know, I never want to, you know, like just, I don't want to be that person. I always want to be a nice person. Masha is not the kind of person I would ordinarily seek out. Not my type. Is that fair to say?
Sure.
Okay. But all these months later, I still get a message every morning from Masha Barbie.
Masha Barbie.
Barbie messages me daily. So, thanks to our three random words, I am now able to replace some of the words that she's used in her morning message to me with words that you suggested. And I just can't figure out now, do I do this with glasses on or glasses off? This is becoming very complicated. What? Where is this coming from? come on. Okay. A morning reading from Masha Barbie. On OnlyFans, but replacing naughty words in her message with your words. I'm now without a Milky Way.
Ooh.
In beautiful pants. There are stickers on my Shazam. But I will now take all my Tarzans off, and you can see me well. Do you want this?
I want to see that Milky Way and that Tarzan.
My morning message from Masha Barbie.
Let's go.
Masha Barbie. Oh, she's wearing lovely. Oh, she's wearing love. Oh, she's matching today. Her iPhone case and her zip up. We'll call them faux vinyl pants.
Sure.
Okay. With her matching heart-shaped pasties.
Right.
Which have the frills on, the little spinny frilly thingies on them. Looking very, very nice. She's changed her hair color today. It's kind of a salt and pepper effect. Very, very, very sultry. Masha Barbie.
There you go.
My first message of the morning.
While you were talking about Masha Barbie.
Oh, yes.
We've had a donation of 5,000 bits.
What?
100 bits. 100, 100, 100, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Yeah, so looks like Tara has donated a bunch by the looks of it.
Holy moly.
If I understand Twitch correctly, I don't understand all this technology.
Okay. Well, listen, anything that is donated, thank you. I will certainly be able to go. Where is this noise coming from? I have everything turned off.
I mean, I don't know how it's mine because my computer is.
Anything you donate between today, anything donated today between now and 1 o'clock, Robert's Smart Center will be the beneficiaries.
Right.
There you go. which again is a which is a center for youth in Ottawa. They've helped so many young people with mental health issues, etc. And again, it's been my privilege for a lot of years to MC their annual golf tournament, typically late summer, early fall, and I missed being able to do that this year. And I'm sure they are short of funds as well. So yeah, happy to donate that to. That's just yeah. Listen, they've got their day, I got mine,
yep,
and this just helps me overcome the triggers. You know what? When I write my book, and my book is going to be finally written, I will probably be able to find a way to really sort of tell my story. And it's not everyone's story. And I'm let me summarize this day by saying this. I applaud the initiative. I like, I'm trying to be serious. I applaud the initiative. I applaud the initiative. I would like to see the company behind it do better by their own employees.
Right.
There.
That makes sense. Yeah.
Let me just leave it at that. The Senators, Eric, speaking of sports, I know we're kind of flip-flopping all over the place. By the way, this is the morning brew. Ha ha. Having a good laugh, trying to figure out where these noises are coming from. hope you're laughing along with us for the most part today. We invite you to be part of the show. You can call in, you can text in, or you can join us on Zoom. The number is the same, 613-606-8786. I believe it's up on the screen. Yes, it is. So there you go.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, because yesterday we had a bunch of random people on Twitch just sort of surfing through, and they thought, like Ginger from South Carolina.
Yeah. That was awesome.
I see a Zoom ID. I'm just going to dial it. I love that.
I know. Isn't that awesome? Howard says, John, it's coming from Facebook.
But it can't be, Howard.
I don't know.
Because nothing on my mixing board would have Facebook. Stand by. Okay.
Stand by.
Mistress M. I sent a transfer for your donation. Oh my god, guys! Are you kidding me right now? Okay, I'm gonna.
Ha! My mother-in-law's now following.
Do I have to behave myself now?
I don't know. Maybe.
Now I've got your mom and your mother-in-law following me. I don't know, Eric. Okay,
I know, right?
So the computer that you're on, I have been logged into Facebook on. Okay. So now I've logged out of Facebook on that computer, so I should not be receiving notifications. Correct.
Bling. You shouldn't be if you're not logged on out. Facebook on there.
But
yeah,
but I have been logged into that account at all times in days previous. So why have we not heard the magic music before?
I mean, I have to be honest. Until today, I haven't seen that little zombie shot like pop up on the screen at all.
Oh, he's cool.
So
isn't
maybe
he?
Maybe that's why.
I love zombie guy.
Because zombie guy hasn't shown up. No bits have been shared while I've been on the show. Because you know it's. So maybe that's the reason why.
That sounded so self-disparaging. Nobody ever donates bits when I'm on the show, man.
Nope. I get it.
No. Stop. So this...
my mother-in-law says, no, you don't need to behave.
Apple doesn't fall far from the tree, home.
Well, you know.
I kind of know your wife a little bit, so I can say
yes.
That.
Yes. That's true. You do know her.
Dommy's fun. Hello, mother-in-law.
Yeah.
So there you go. That's, you know what, Howard? I think you may have actually nailed it. So, because there was a delay, right? Like I would see the zombie walking across the screen that I've got Eric on, and then it'd be like a few minutes later, I would actually hear the bring. So that would make sense then if I'm relaying that feed to Facebook that there would be a delay. Anyway,
yeah.
Let's see now that I've turned that off whether or not we still hear the magical music.
Maybe.
Back to sports last night. The Ottawa.
Nope, it's still there. I don't know what that is. That's really weird.
I give up, man. What is going on?
I mean, I don't know how it could be on my end because
I don't understand.
I mean, unless. I think he's lost it, guys. I think he's completely lost it. We've broken Melky.
It doesn't make any sense.
Milk you down.
Oh, you know what? I'm living in fear that this happens on the Lowell Green Show this afternoon. And then I got to explain it to Lowell because, you know, he's just going to be like, he'll be on like in the middle of some rant. Prime Minister this, Prime Minister that, grr, grr, lies, lies, lies.
Oh boy, that's hilarious. You okay? You having a heart attack? Does anybody know Milky's address? Can call 911. I think he's gonna croak. Okay.
911 knows who I am. It's good.
That's true.
Yeah, hi. Just calling for a regular checkup on. Stop! What is it? Where is it coming from? Where?
I mean, I can log out of Twitch on my computer and see if that helps, but I don't know how it is because my Twitch is like muted.
Okay, okay. So the computer that's not wired into the studio at all.
Yeah.
At all. It just runs the video feed.
Right.
Oh my God. I've now muted the audio on that. Let's just see. Oh my God. Anyways, if you call 911, just have them, you know, hi, just calling for a regular checkup on John Milky, though. Oh yeah, that guy.
Yeah, that guy, we got it. So Bill 71 says, I think this episode needs to be titled the WTF episode, LOL.
Ah, Bill's obviously discovered that we actually do have this as a podcast. Thank you. That explains why we've gone from one download of our podcast to three.
Three. Woo-woo. Download the podcast.
And I've kind of been adopting that as the title for each. So this is I think we had the yesterday was the first U.S. guest episode. We have the Dauda. Dauda.
Yeah.
I don't know. Phone call coming in. Hang on.
Oh, hey, wait.
It's the Milky Show. Hello.
Hey, John. It's Howard.
Howard. You sexy son of a gun, you. Thank you so much. $100 going to the Robert Smart Center. You are beyond genuine and beyond kind. Thank you so much for your generosity.
Oh, no, that's my pleasure, man. It's an awesome show, you know, awesome brouhaha. I just wanted to tell you that it is coming from Facebook.
But how?
Paul has been testing it because I shared it. It came up on the screen with the little guy.
So you're messing with me.
Tom has shared it multiple times.
So you're messing with me on purpose.
Yes, on purpose. But you're right about one thing with Lowell. If that continues on during Lowell show, it will be some conspiracy theory that everybody's after him.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
You know what, Howard? You know what would make that even better?
What?
If I could make the sound happen only on the right.
It's the liberals after him.
Except I can't even figure out what the source of the damn thing is, let alone pan it left or right.
Yeah.
It's definitely coming from Facebook because Tom Nickerson, who I know.
I know Tom very well.
Just shared it again.
Tom's awesome. Former radio guy too. See, it's there's Tom messaging me right now. Whenever I share, you're getting attention notification. Ha 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 ha. So now that
share.
But now that I've muted, so like I said, I've got a computer in the studio that runs, it all it does is run the video portion and pick up the audio from the board. So there's no audio feed coming from that computer back into the radio station. It's strictly an output computer only. Now that I've muted it.
Well, all I can tell you is that you better have it fixed before 2:00.
No kidding, right?
Oh my God.
Because you know what'll be even worse? It'll start happening, and then I will lose my, I'll start laughing like I've been laughing in the middle of Lowell. Like I said, Lowell will be ranting, Prime Minister lying, where are vaccines? People are dying. And there I am. Bling.
I'll definitely be tuning in at 2:00.
Yeah, right. Thanks.
Yeah, I know. So note to self, everybody tune in at 2:00 and start sharing the feed and then see
and
what
share
happens.
Share the feed, exactly.
Yeah, the real beneficiary in this whole day is the Lowell Green Show. Watch his numbers quadruple. Let's see if the sounds happen on the Lowell Green Show.
Yeah.
Howard, I can't wait till this pandemic is over. You are someone I clearly need to just, you know, get to know a little bit, and at the very least just, you know, buy you a drink and say thank you for being so kind. And to the listener, I don't know if you know this, but Howard has been incredibly generous through Twitch and supporting us, and to say the least, is a big reason why we are still on the air at this point. Yep. So, Howard, thank you.
Matt, thank you, Howard. You know what? My pleasure. I'll tell you what. I found you not because of Lowell. You keep saying it's because of Lowell Green. It wasn't that. I work from home. I've worked from home for like 15 years now, and I was looking for.
It's nice to be able to wear leggings and heels, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely.
I know, girl. I know.
Absolutely. And I remember, you know, of course, I remember, you know, listening to you on normal terrestrial radio.
Normal.
And then I found you on the internet. So, I mean, ever since then, boom. I have you on when I can.
Not boom. Not boom.
Well, no, sorry. Not blast. Boom. Yeah. You know what I mean.
I do.
It's not a boom. It's a blast.
It's a blast. There you go. And by the way, so Tom is still messing with me. Thank you, Tom. And I think the sounds have gone. So I think that's what the problem was. For some reason,
yes.
I don't know how it feeds back into the system, but it definitely does. I mean, it's one thing to hear it, you know, in the studio, that computer's speakers make a sound in the studio. But that was coming right through on the air. Like, that was clear as day.
Yeah, that was weird.
So, Howard, however you found us, I'm so grateful that you're here, and I'm really glad you enjoy it. Please keep telling your friends, your dog, your neighbor, your cat, and please be listening at 2 o'clock this afternoon to see if we can sabotage the Lowell Green Show.
Oh, I definitely will. I definitely will. Thanks,
right.
Guys.
Get off my phone, Howard. Goodbye. That's how it's done. There you go. Howard's first time on the air with us. Yay! Our number here is 613-606-8786. That is our Zoom ID as well. You can call, you can text. So back to the Ottawa Senators on a road trip out west and stinking up the Vancouver arena.
Yeah, so they played on Monday night and kind of fell apart, and they lost 7-1. And last night, it was better. They played better, but they lost 5-1.
That's better.
And then they play again tonight in Vancouver at 10 o'clock. So maybe tonight's game will be a 3-1 loss because they've just allowed two less goals.
It's all about narrowing the gap now, is it?
Just narrow that gap. And then. So, I mean, they play tonight at 10 o'clock Eastern time in Vancouver. And it's, like I say, it's the third game out of 3 in 4 days against the Canucks. And then they head off to Edmonton, I think, for a couple games.
So this is making a Sens fans are starting to sound like the way we talk about, we didn't win that one. This is, you know, we'll narrow the gap. Yay. Now we're starting to sound like Leafs fans who, you know, like you and I have a friend in common who is speaking of OnlyFans, who is a huge, huge Leafs fan. Right.
Yes. Yes, she is. Yes.
I think I know who you're talking about. Yeah. So, and posted a thing last night where it's like the Toronto Maple Leafs are like number one and right behind them, the Las Vegas Golden Knights. And it's like, girl, that's not even like essentially they're not even playing in the same league right now. Like, it's an all Canadian division. Like, they're just these visions of like they're just Leafs fans. I love you. I love you. And I would kill to have fans as devoted to my brand as you are to that hockey team. Believe me. But you are delusional. And it's so freaking fun to watch. Look at us. We're number one. Yeah. Now, are the Leafs number one overall in the league?
I believe so, yes.
All right.
Yes, they are number one in the league. They have their own division.
Fine.
Obviously, everyone's in their own divisions and stuff like that, like always. But yeah, I mean, it is one of those things where, I mean, I've been a hockey fan since I was probably in high school.
A year or two ago.
Yeah. Funny. Yeah.
Shut up.
But yeah, so, and I mean, it's one of those things where growing up back home, the only hockey you could watch was the Leafs because we were like Northwestern Ontario. There was nothing else on TV. They never showed any other teams. So, I mean, I was into hockey back then, but I didn't really get hardcore into hockey until I moved to Ottawa. And then I started to follow the Senators and I started to like, I went and worked for the Senators at the box office and that just like kind of springboarded my craziness for hockey. And I mean, I've said it all along, and I've said it from day one since I've been in Ottawa, is if Senators fans were like the Leafs fans, like we'd be in a completely different atmosphere, because I mean, everyone says, oh, like I as a Sens fan, a lot of people I know will be like, oh, I am never stepping foot in Canadian Tire Center for a Sens and Leafs game because it's so many Leafs fans. It's like, yeah, because Sens fans don't want to show up.
Sens fans are very placid. Ottawa by nature is just, look, you can't compare Ottawa and Toronto.
No, you know, you can't.
We're just, first, I mean, Toronto is the economic engine of our country, right? Yeah. And Toronto, besides Bay Street, besides that, Toronto is just, I mean, by sheer nature of its size, etc., it's also a very blue collar area. Outside the downtown core of Toronto, you get into very working class, you yes. know, yeah, you know, typically your sports fan, you know, who works their ass off all day as a plumber, electrician, truck driver, delivery person, whatever, you know, works really hard at the end of the day and wants to come home and just put their feet up, watch something on TV with a beer in their hand and some chicken wings and enjoy themselves. And they are passionate about it and they grow up on it. And I get it. Ottawa is a very, it's your typical public service government town.
Yeah.
Right?
No, and that's totally, totally legit, because, I mean, like, in Toronto, it is one of those situations where, like, Leafs season tickets get handed down from grandparent to parent to child to their child.
And by the way, I'm not trying to imply that public service people don't work hard. They do.
No.
But.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
But your position within the government and what, you know, just the way you're wired, knowing that that job is there for you tomorrow, knowing the benefits that you've got, you know, the education that you had to have first off in order to get there, you know, it makes you a different, you're just differently wired than, you know, the average grunt like me.
Yeah.
You know, but yeah, I mean, I don't know what it is, Eric, but you're right. Going to a Leafs game in Toronto would probably be a whole other experience because everybody's on board. When you get into a situation, I mean, because the Leafs have been around for so long and the Habs have been around for so long, that in a market like this that is so close to both of those, you've got allegiances to both teams. Plus the fact that in Toronto and oftentimes in Montreal, you can't even get tickets to see your home team. So you travel, you know, an hour and a half or 4 hours up the highway.
Yeah.
I got my choice of seats in the arena. You know,
yeah.
And the other the other problem is, I mean, in Toronto, because we're a government town and the majority of us in Ottawa are working for the government, the seats at a hockey game or a football game or anything, they're not a tax write-off, right? Like, oftentimes it's a business that owns the tickets, so that's a tax write-off for me. I bought these for promotion. I bought these as an incentive for employees, as an incentive for customers. Therefore, it is something that is tax deductible to me as a business. And then I can hand the tickets to you. The public service is forbidden from doing that.
Right. You know, and that's exactly it. And that's why, like, I mean, in Toronto,
that's where I was going with the blue collar versus white collar thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, in Toronto, for instance, like, my uncle's company has, like, season tickets to, like, the Raptors, the Leafs, the Blue Jays, like, Toronto FC, all the different sports teams. And it, again, yeah, like, obviously, like, it's okay, well, who wants the tickets to take a potential client or to take a current client?
Right.
Like, that's just the way that a lot of the Leafs, like, Toronto sports teams work for these big companies. But like you say,
phone call coming if you in, work Eric? For the, phone call coming in. Sorry, we got a phone call coming in. 613-606-8786. Morning, brouhaha. Who's this?
Johnny.
Hi, Johnny.
No, it's not Johnny. It's Tom.
Well, Tom, I asked who you were, and you said it was Johnny. Now you're lying to me. Not only are you fucking with me on
Johnny
Facebook. No. Not only are you messing with me on Facebook, now you're fucking with me on the phone, too.
I was trying to help.
No, you're not helping,
to
help though.
Solve the problem.
No, you're not helping, though. When I ask you who you are and you say Johnny, and then you come around and you tell me that you're, I mean, you might as well be, we might as well just call you Justin. If you're going to lie to me, we might as well just call you Justin.
I like the name Justin. But...
Thank you, Tom, for helping, or whoever you are. Thank you for helping us solve the issue this morning. I still don't understand why Again,
that
like,
works.
Yeah,
so much.
It makes sense for it to come through on that computer's speakers. But again, Tom, you run a DJ business, right?
I did. Yeah, I don't anymore.
Okay, and you were in radio for some time, right?
Yes.
What I'm trying to get at is you have an understanding of how audio systems are wired up.
There is
no audio output coming from that one computer into this studio. So how it, like, it's one thing to hear it, you know, ambiently in the studio. Is ambiently a word? It is now.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. It is now.
I'm making it a word. But for it to, like, that, dude, that was so obvious coming through on the air. Like, it was undeniable it was coming through on the air somehow. So I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. Anyway,
all
thank
the
you.
Wonders of technology.
Every 5 years I hear from Tom and he's just here to solve problems. You obviously listen a lot more than you let on. Or
I love it. Love it.
Aw, thanks, buddy. Or have you just,
and I love it even more that now that I know that Howard's listening too. I love Howard. He's a great guy.
Howard's my sugar daddy.
There you go.
There you go.
How is my sugar daddy? Tom, have you been listening all this time, like over the last couple of years? Because I know you used to. We used to talk back and forth
about
it.
Yeah, on and off. I'm working from home, so.
Did we win you back because we're on Facebook Live now?
Yeah, it helps.
Booyah!
It helps. I can just have it on in the background, get my headphone in, and I can still actually quote-unquote work.
Quote-unquote work. There you go. Yeah.
What are you doing these days?
Hopefully
you're not
running... none of my... I work for Queens University.
Okay. Nice.
So hopefully none of my coworkers are watching the show.
Nah.
I'm supposed to be working.
They're supposed to be working too. They're watching you porn.
Yeah.
That's true.
They've all got, they're all looking for Masha Barbie.
Yeah.
Who is this person?
Who is it?
She seems very nice. You know? I don't know. Just not not my type of person, but you know.
Yeah, you know.
I mean, she may be the nicest person. I may be doing myself.
Just don't
a huge
hang
disorder.
Around with her near a candle.
Well,
that's
all.
No.
Anyway, okay. I'll pull back a little bit on it. With me having discovered Pink Whitney, all bets are off. Maybe Masha Barbie is someone I would talk to at the end of the night. I don't know.
Maybe. Depends on how much
you
Whitney
never
you have.
Tom, thanks for being our Mr. Fix-It today, or Johnny, or whoever you
are. Thank you. Good to talk to you on this wonderful you-know-what day, but thinking of you on this day.
Is what it is, my man. Again, I applaud the initiative. Let's make sure that, you know, we make sure every day
every day.
Conversation is
today.
At the forefront. Exactly.
Yep.
Gotcha. Aw, Tom.
Okay, man, you have a good day.
Dude, it's nice to hear your voice. Now I'm going to hang up on you. Unceremoniously.
Bye, Tom.
Okay. Okay, love, bye. Mwah. there you go. Tom calling. Listen, wow, two phone calls on the show today. This is awesome.
I know, and our friend Ginger was in the Twitch chat. I don't know if she's still
Ginger. Oh, there she is. Hi. Yeah. Hey, girl. She said, okay, what'd she say? She's sitting in her car. Aw. She's sitting in her car watching Twitch on her cell phone, obviously. She's not sure whether a Zoom call would go well.
Okay.
I can appreciate that. Although, I mean, her internet, she was, you know, pooping on her internet yesterday.
But it held up better than Dota's.
You know. So what else is going on today? So did you say the Sens were playing tonight?
They played tonight at 10 o'clock again in Vancouver.
See, that's too late.
Yeah.
It's too late. You know what I miss? I miss having the sounds on the...
Yeah, I miss the sounds now.
All right, the sounds are back on. Now that I know where they're coming from, the sounds are back on. It was encouraging goodness in our feed.
Yeah, there you go.
What else is going on today? Anything exciting? God, it's almost the end of the month. Can you believe that?
I know. It's already the 28th.
What have I got in the forecast for Ottawa today? A few flurries, minus 12 for the high. Minus 17 tonight. By the way, for our friends in the United States, that's 11 Fahrenheit. That's our high today.
Right.
Live from the igloo. Oh, I know what happens today.
What happens today,
John? How could I forget? It's the opening of the Rideau Canal.
Woo! That no one can go to unless you live in the Glebor in Center Town or like Lower Town or whatever.
Yes, congratulations to the 7 people in this city who live in close enough proximity to a World Heritage site called the Rideau Canal that you can actually skate on it, provided you don't have a hockey stick, provided you have a mask on. I've lost track now. There it is. there's this whole Chinese way. Have you seen the new Chinese method of testing for COVID?
Yeah, the anal swabs.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, no, that'll go over well.
You thought wearing a mask was uncomfortable. Wait until it's mandated. We all got to be butt plugged before we go places.
Yep, exactly. Yep, there you go.
And Eric, I don't want to be the one to break this to you, but the next time you go to work at your little wine store there in the Merivale Mall, you'll be the one charged with the responsibility of ensuring everyone is in compliance.
Yeah, hard no. No. I will give my lack of 2 weeks my I'm not, bye. Thank you. Bye bye.
I mean, if you've got, where is it? It's in here somewhere.
Uh oh.
I'm destroying my stuff.
What are you pulling out of your bag of tricks now?
Just a thing.
Just a thing.
There it is. Okay. So yeah,
there are things.
There are lots of things. This is okay. So, if
oh, there you go.
Yeah. If the person's using the right plug.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at that one. Beautifully bejeweled.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, beautiful gem. Yeah.
Not my birthstone, but whatever.
No.
You know, that's that. A metal detector would probably tip you off to the fact that that person's in compliance.
Yeah, exactly. Like, is on an international flight with butt plug in there. Just, yeah.
You know what's really sad?
Be like, I don't know what's going on. Why am I dinging when I go through security at the airport? And then they're like, oh, let's check. And it's like, do you have something up your rectum? It's like, yes, I do.
The number of times I've been able to reach into my drawer and pull that out as a prop on this show is like, there's no, like, that should never, ever be something that comes up in conversation ever. And yet the number of times I've been able to reach in there and use that as a prop.
Yeah. Yep. Good times.
It's really not right. So yeah, so this is not the latest that the Rideau Canal has opened, but it's like sort of second on the list of late dates.
Yeah, it's pretty late. Yeah.
And I mean, typically once we get into February, which has traditionally been the coldest month of the year, usually Winterlude is the first three weekends of February.
Yep.
This year it'll be virtual, I guess.
Yeah. Are they all virtual?
Are they actually going to be like do the sculptures, but then barricade them off so that nobody can be near them? Is that the deal?
I don't know. I haven't actually heard. I just know that there are all sorts of online fun and
hey kids,
stuff like,
let's gather around the iPad and
tour the city,
virtually
of
tour ice sculptures.
Yay! Yeah. And virtually take a virtual ride down the snow hills in the Jacques Cartier Park. Or
let's have a virtual beaver tail and a virtual hot chocolate while we virtually tour the ice sculptures in virtual Ottawa.
And virtually skate on the canal. There you go. I mean, you can't get close enough.
I'm not trying to knock it. I mean, what else do you do, right? I mean,
I know. It's crazy.
There is no other option. I'm not mocking it. I think the whole thing is sad.
Yep.
You know, and I'm glad they're doing it. And my hope is, and I haven't even Googled to see if I can even access it. My hope is, you know, maybe these are tours of years gone by and people can actually, you know, take the time and see what they've missed so that in a perfect world, come next year, 2022, we can actually, go outside again.
Yeah. Well, that's exactly it, right?
Walk through a snow sculpture.
Yeah.
Diversity in Capital says we have a beaver tail shack on Hunt Club. No,
we used
don't.
To, but it's gone
no,
now.
No, we don't. That's right in Eric's neck of the woods too. That's literally a block from Eric's place. That was the. I wish that was. Oh, I wish and I don't that it was still there.
Yeah, and then yeah, like and you're kind of in that like, hey, there's a beaver tail over there, and then I saw your comment on their post saying that No Forks Given needs to open up in your driveway.
No Forks Given, by the way, who are closed. At the moment, again, unfortunately, it's a logistics thing. They expect to reopen at a new location soon.
Which will be in John's driveway.
It may very well be in my driveway, and I have absolutely no complaints about that. But yeah.
No, and the only rent you'll be charging is free food.
Yes.
Like, I will not charge you rent. You just have to make sure you feed me three meals a day.
Oh my God. The kettle chips though. The kettle chips. anyway, Diversity in the Capital, Andre, the shack may well be there. And listen, I stand to be corrected, but when I went for beaver tails, which was before Christmas, they were set up. Yep. There was that's what is it? Kiwan Farms, is that the name of it?
Yes.
So that's
right at Hunt Club and Hawthorne.
Yeah. So the actual farm is just up the road a little bit. Yeah. And then they sell, you know, fruits, vegetables and stuff throughout the year there. It's a gorgeous little barn that they've got right on that corner. They had a little Christmas
market.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Like I drove by one time and I saw like people lined up at the Beaver Tails. Yeah. I saw people sitting by like a fire pit. And,
they had
like,
pictures. They had Santa there and they were doing dog photos with Santa. You know, you're only a couple blocks from the Conroy Dog Park. Why not? Anyway, when I asked them at the time, if they were there for the whole winter, they said, no, just till Christmas. So that's what I was told. If somebody knows otherwise and they're still and, open, let me know now, and I will hit the auto start on the milk truck, and I will continue this conversation as I boogie down Hunt Club Road.
The shack may be there. They just might not be open anymore. So
entirely possible, but boy, you know what? And you know, I'm sitting here dreaming. Oh, please let it be open. Please let it be open. Please. All the years that I worked in the Byward Market, the
building
right next door
that has the main Beaver Tails, like literally almost practically attached to the building.
Yes. And I managed to successfully walk past it every single day on my way back to my vehicle. I wasn't so strong-willed to walk right past the Byward Cafe. Oh, no, I'd still pop into the Byward Cafe, and I would still get my Caesar wrap, and don't tell anybody, but I'd like the Tiger Tail brownie, please. I probably was better off with a Beaver Tail, frankly.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So I was gonna bring up a story. If Kathy was here, but I'll bring it up anyways. I saw it on the news last night.
I'll play the role of Kathy. Hang on. Do you like my lipstick?
Yes. Looks fantastic.
Okay, good.
Thank you.
All right.
but anyways, so apparently there's a story on the news last night about a rare phenomenon that happened twice at the same farm in Shaunavon, Saskatchewan. Do you know this is?
No.
So for the first time, I think they said ever in Saskatchewan, two separate cows from the same farm within 24 hours gave birth to triplets.
Wow. I didn't know cows didn't know cows could do that.
So yeah, like they interviewed the guy on the radio last night or on the TV on the news last night, and he's like, yeah, so like we birthed the first one and then we saw the second one coming out and I joked with my son and said, oh, reach in there, see if there's a third. And sure enough, he pulls out a third one. And then it was like within 24 hours, the same, like a different cow birthed triplets as well. And it was the first time I think in Saskatchewan history or in that farm's history or like whatever that two separate cows on the same farm had triplets within a day of each other.
So is that how it got the term triple A beef?
Yeah, maybe.
Hi. Thanks, live here all week. Morning, brouhaha.
But yeah, and
that's cool.
Terry even said it is pretty rare. Often one dies, and this is the thing that was crazy about it was the vet for the farm was like they're all like abnormally big for having triplets. Because I mean, even when you have kids and you have triplets, usually they're pretty small when they're born. Like you don't have 3 9-pound triplets. It's like, let's say 2 or 3 pounds each or whatever the case may be. So these ones were actually fairly decent size and they were all healthy and they've all survived. I mean, knock on wood so far, but I mean, there was no issues with any of them. Jeez. Because typically one of them, at least one of them has the situation where it's like where one of them passes away either during birth or shortly after birth.
That's amazing. Yeah, funny things you don't think about, right? Like cows could have twins, cows could have triplets. Amazing.
Yeah. My mom even just messaged me on Facebook and says cows having triplets is very rare. Usually one is neglected, as is the case in sheep as well. I mean, she grew up on a farm, so she would know.
She would know.
So I guess my mom is listening. So mom, if you want to call in and give us some insight on the farm, go right ahead. 613-606-8786.
You're getting too good at this, Eric. You're getting way too good at this. Story I came across last night that you listen, if you're a James Bond fan, you got to love this. The LCBO, that's the Liquor Control Board of Ontario. It's where you buy your booze in Ontario, is now selling a Scotch whiskey. Love me a good Scotch whiskey. And it comes in a genuine 1964 Aston Martin DB5 piston.
Wow.
Yep. It sells for $85,000. The DB5 Aston Martin, by the way, 1964, is the vehicle that James Bond drove.
Yep.
So if you're a real James Bond fan. Oh, Howard. If you really want to be generous, that in the movie Goldfinger, that's the vehicle that he drove. That was the Aston Martin. $85,000. Okay, let's be real. We've all obtained at some point or another a bottle of something that we've looked at and gone, this is way beyond my means. Like
Howard just said in the Twitch chat, I put an order for one bottle.
I mean, I would appreciate even just to be able to say, I put my lips on some $85,000 Scotch whiskey.
I know, right?
I mean, what? I'll be 52 next month. I'm trying to think, what would be the most expensive booze I've ever tasted?
Right.
I mean.
Yeah, and Howard says it's the Scotch I want. And then Tara says, that's a lot of bits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
but I mean, like, maybe the better question is this. And this goes back to the old blind taste tests that they used to do between Coke and Pepsi. Can you actually tell the difference? Okay, so I blindfold you. Stop with the naughty thoughts. We're not doing that. It's not Valentine's Day yet.
I was going to say it's on promise a good time.
There's no handcuffs involved. It's strictly a blindfold. Okay, so we blindfold you and we sit you down and one glass that I pour for you is an $8 bottle of Scotch whiskey.
Yeah.
The next thing that I pour you is the $85,000 Scotch whiskey in a real 1964 Aston Martin DB5 piston.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe $8 and $85. Okay, maybe you can tell the difference. Let's go I from an $80 bottle of Scotch. That's a pretty expensive bottle of Scotch whiskey, right? I wouldn't spend $80 on a bottle of Scotch whiskey for myself.
No.
I've probably spent $50. 80 okay. starting to get into the for Christmas. No. And even then it would probably take me 3 to 4 years to even get around to that, right?
And even
at $80 a bottle, I would treat it as a real special treat occasion kind of. But could you tell the difference, do you think, if I gave you a little taste of an $80 bottle of Scotch whiskey and then an $85,000 bottle of Scotch whiskey?
I probably wouldn't be able to tell because I don't drink whiskey or scotch or really anything, to be honest.
Well, then why the hell did I bring this up on the show?
I don't know.
Why didn't you stop me? What's wrong with you?
I just don't.
You don't know where the sounds are coming from in the studio? You don't know why the sims are losing?
You blame that on my computer, but it was yours.
It's just easier if I blame it on somebody else. Listen, in fairness,
it's like, well, Eric's got a brand new mixer. He doesn't know what he's doing. Yes. It's got to be coming from him.
Yes, in fairness, the only new thing that happened was on your end.
That's I mean,
right?
That's understandable.
You and your fancy
right,
mixer. By the way, Eric, how did you get your mixer and microphone working?
So I have this amazing friend. His name is John.
Your own sugar daddy.
I have my own sugar daddy for USB cables and power. He knows what it takes to plug me in.
Yes, hang on.
So yes, he
yes, 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 I do.
Yes, yes, yes you do. So I got a delivery yesterday of a power cable and a USB cable from someone who happens to run a radio station or something, from what I understand.
Remember we had all the radio people. Remember we had all the radio people on the show the other day, and we were all talking about boxes and boxes and boxes of stuff.
Yeah.
Your Honor, I present Exhibit A.
Yeah, exactly. So yes, no, John came through yesterday. I mean,
there you go.
So and it's all good.
I'm happy. Oh, listen, I'm glad it worked out for you. I think the mic sounds pretty good.
I do too. I like it. Yeah.
Yep. And I'm really impressed too. And I said this before we got on the air today with Eric. I in the back of my mind, I'm going, okay, so the real trick in this, like when plugging a USB microphone in, and by the way, Andre, as an aside,
Andre,
The show last night sounded amazing. Not to brag, but I think the USB microphone I loaned you really made a difference. I hope you noticed it too. Just talking about gear that I'm loaning out. Diversity in the Capital last night was fantastic. Great interview that he had with Carol Pope.
There's that noise again.
So I've got gear on loan all over the place. But when you plug in the USB microphones to the computer, yes, they're built in. Typically they've got a headphone jack built into the microphone, so you can still monitor the conversation.
Yep.
Right? So now you have gone from using the typical USB microphone, the Blue Yeti, which most podcasters use. It's readily available. Staples has it, Walmart, Best Buy. It's a buy it off the shelf kind of thing. Now you've gone all fancy Nancy on us. And you've hooked up like what I would say to be probably the best entry level broadcast mic out there, the AT2020. I've got a few of them in my collection as well, plugged into the mixer. But intuitively, the mixer doesn't give you that back feed from the computer. So I was in my mind last night, I'm going, should I have a conversation with Eric? Should we test this out tonight, or? You know, do I just assume that he's going to figure this all out and not butt in? And you showed up this morning, and I'm like, okay, here we go. And I turn on the microphone. I'm like, hello, hello. And you're like, hi. And then, bling, where's the music when you need it?
I know, right?
And you got it all figured out. So good on you, man. Now, initially, I guess it wasn't quite working that way, right? So you and a friend worked on it last night and figured it out?
So, yeah, one of my classmates, I messaged him and I was like, okay, so I have my microphone plugged in. I have my headphones plugged in. I'm like, I've opened my Adobe Audition and I'm like recording and going, check 1, 2, test. And it's not recognizing my voice. I'm like, okay, I know it's plugged in properly. What do I do? And then, so I jumped on Zoom with him and I was like, hey man. He's like, I can't hear you. I was like, hey man. He's like, I still can't hear. I'm like, I can hear you, but you can't hear me. How do I do this? He's like, grab your USB like webcam. He's like, show me your mixer. And he's like, okay, see that button? Yeah. Click that.
Aux feeds back. Yeah.
And it's like, now can you hear me? No, not yet. What about that one? Now can you hear me? Oh, I can hear you. So it was entertaining, but it worked out.
And they're like snowflakes, Eric. I'm going to warn you now. No two are alike.
No.
I mean, the hoops I had to jump through in order to be able to run the phone calls for Lowell Green to be able to hear them. So initially, and here's the ridiculous thing. So initially, in the studio, when I started producing the Lowell Green show from here, so I mean, let's forget about the Lowell in his own office trying to make things happen, you know, with me explaining it to him as quickly as I can, you know, on a Sunday. Okay, so now everything's in my studio. So initially, I couldn't get, like, it's easy to plug the headphone jack of your cell phone into a mixing board and then take the audio that you hear on that cell phone and stream it. That's simple, except. If you're old like we are, you've probably seen headphones, and headphones on the end of them have got what? You've got, here's an example. You have two rings, right?
Yes.
You have two rings. That is stereo. The rings separate your left and your right audio. Well, now we're living in a world where most of these little headphones have got three rings. Well, what's that? Well, one is your left audio, one is your right audio, and the other one is microphone input. So it's all built into one little thing now. And so if the pins don't align properly, you either don't hear or they don't hear you and all kinds. It just becomes a big old mess. So there's actually, so when I had Lowell going on initially, yep, fine. I had a headphone adapter plugged into the phone and then into the mixer. And in order for Lowell to be able to hear what the caller was saying, I had to quickly turn down my microphone so it didn't feedback and crank the studio monitors.
No, no.
So that the caller, the caller's voice would come booming through the microphone on the cell phone and Lowell would strain to hear what the person was saying. Anyway, so yeah, no, I found a contraption that actually takes the cell phone and splits it up and divides it and this, that, the other thing and all the aux ones and aux twos and feedbacks, and you figured it out in a night. Well, where the hell were you when I was trying to set Lowell Green up?
I don't know.
Damn. It seems to me like as I get older and more forgetful, it's going to be a good thing that I've aligned myself with you to try and figure things out. This is the Morning Brouhaha. If you love the show, and you can't catch the show every single day, that's okay. We record the show and we make it available as a podcast. So you can just ask your smart speaker to play the Morning Brouhaha podcast. You can also find the Morning Brouhaha on Spotify, on Google, on Apple, and you can be part of the show. Our friend Ginger is still with us. Yay! She was part of the show yesterday. If we can get calls from South Carolina, why can we not get calls from South Mountain?
I know, right? Well, we had one from Kempville.
Well, that's true. We had Howard and we had, well, Tom called from Kingston, so there's that.
There's that. There you go.
Anyway, whether you want to call, you want to text, or you want to be part of our Zoom, the number's the same, 613-606-8786. We're on for another 15 minutes or so. Anything you want to talk about? Anything at all. Eric, what else is on your mind? This is the best therapy you're going to get. We're all here for you. Eric, what's on your mind?
Well, let's see. I don't know. I really don't know, man.
Now you're sounding like someone who has attended the radio broadcasting school of John Mielke.
Good times. Good times.
But at least we hear you loud and clear. So here we go. We've got a text coming in. Goldschlager would be the most expensive I've ever had, says this person. Tara is on the phone. Oh, God. Finn's mom is calling. What did I do now?
Nothing. You didn't do anything. You do great things.
I do great things. By the way, I'm sorry if I excited you when I talked about blindfolds.
No, I was just calling in to speak about the day that must not be named. Right. It's kind of very Harry Potter-ish.
I mean, listen, it's not that I don't want to talk about it. It's just...
I understand, John. You don't have to explain. I understand.
I applaud the initiative. I have other places I choose to support.
Yep.
Yeah, and there's so many ways to support mental health initiatives, especially now, that people don't have to be pigeonholed into one way of supporting mental health. There are ways everywhere you turn to support mental health, both financially, but like just in your community and between your family members and your friends. So and it's basically just opening up a dialogue or a conversation. But I just want to call in and say thank you for all the things that you do with our family, for donating the mic way back.
Oh, Tara, listen.
John, come on. And
To help. How many times has my security camera alerted me to your presence at my house versus how many times have you been alerted to my presence at your house? First off, you're out in the damn woods in the middle of nowhere. I'm afraid that if I were to set foot on your property, I'd probably hear gunshots because that's how y'all live out there. Here in the city, we just stick our dog on you. Lick, lick, lick. Hug, hug, hug.
I like the effect for the camera in your driveway.
Tara, you are a wonderful friend, and for those who don't know or have not heard Finn's Friday forecast, Finn is Tara's amazing son who is just, I mean, he's the real deal. That's the real kid that I met years ago who's just this bright light and just silly and goofy, and you embrace it and you celebrate it and you let him do his thing, and it's amazing. We always look forward to Finn's Friday forecast, and I know we got a couple of irons in the fire, things we're working on. But for you to say that I'm generous to your family is it really is silly for you to say that because I mean, yeah, okay, I've given the kid a microphone here and there and I give him some time on the air, but I mean, How many times have you guys come back from the Netherlands with a suitcase filled with Dutch chocolate that has ended up...
Or the Dutch cheese that looks like white chocolate.
Or cheese.
Oh, yeah, there's that.
Your good old, hey, she gave me white chocolate. I'm just going to take a big chunk out of that. It's like, that's cheese, John. Oh, okay, maybe I better not just take a big bite out of it.
And then as if that's not enough, then they show up weeks ago with custom 14-karat gold big hoop earrings. I don't know if you all know this, but I love me some big hoop earrings with BTR in them. Yep. Which, by the way, has been an interesting, fun thing. When you're looking in the mirror and trying to like make these so that people can read it when you're wearing them, I get them backwards every damn time. You are challenging my logic skills in ways.
But no, seriously, John, I just want to say that just between the, like Bram in the past, in his previous life, has suffered with mental health, and myself, various facets of mental health, and even Finn.
I think we
a major traffic incident where our car was flipped over.
Yep,
and
I remember that.
Just he suffers from anxiety to the point of like puking. And so, I mean, mental health affects everybody. So, I mean, you help us. You know, he's six and he has his own issues at six. So thank you for giving him an outlet of fun every week.
Now I feel even worse about it, because Finn apparently was so upset last Friday, of course, the day that we'll live in infamy, when, I mean, my internet went offline. What can I do about it? Nothing. There's nothing you can do. You are held hostage when your internet, and the poor kid, he's so proud of what he does, right, Tara? He's so excited to do this every single Friday, and he's got a school buddy that he's been bragging to about, you know, I'm on the radio. And they're sitting around and they're waiting to hear Finn do the forecast. And all of a sudden, there's nothing. The station's on like a 6-second loop of playing the same thing over and over and over again, off the air. And I had to send Finn a video and apologize. And I got this little sad sack. It's okay, John. Video back, and I just, dude, you want to talk about soul crushing? Oh my god!
Well, he's authentic. He is. No. Let's record that again so John doesn't die. But you know what? We send the authentic thing. A lot of people go, "Well, is this, you know, something you put on?" And Finn is Finn. Like, there's some weeks where he's grouchy and it comes through when he's doing his forecast, or he's annoyed at his parents and it comes through on his forecast, or he's really excited to share something with his buddy John and it comes through on his forecast, because I was blessed with this enigma, and you never know what the circus that Finn will do.
I mean,
And it's funny because like I've been on Fridays, and I'll hear like John will play his forecast either before we were on or during when we're on or after we're on or whatever. And like I'll hear it, and sometimes it's like, back to you, John, or it's back to you, John. Yep. And then it's like, okay.
It all relates back to the first lesson I gave you, body language. It comes through. It absolutely comes through on the microphone.
It's true.
Please give the boy a hug for me. We're coming up on like last March, like leading up to March break, all Finn and I were talking about back and forth was he was going to come into the studio and he was going to co-host live. He was going to sit here and be part of the show. He was going to push buttons, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And then like a day before March break, all hell breaks loose and we're not supposed to be hanging out and we're in lockdown.
It was a nightmare.
And then you got to explain it to the boy, and Brahm's got to explain it to the boy, and I'm on video chat with him, and he's like, it's okay, I understand there's a germ around right now. So we're coming up on a year where I've been wanting to have the kid in the studio just because he's an awesome kid.
The kid is an elephant. He will never forget. If I tell him something like 3 years ago that I promised him, if I did not fulfill that promise, he will still probably 10 years from now, hey, Mom, remember that day you promised me that thing? And the kid's an elephant. He never forgets.
Are we sure he's not my kid?
He's plagued with my photographic, videographic memory, which is a blessing and a curse.
Yeah.
So, talking about mental health today. So he will never forget. So someday in the future, he'll be like, hey, John.
Yeah, I know. I'm up
like,
for
so,
it.
So, John, now that we can actually see people, you're going to get me in the studio? That's going to be the thing.
Yep. Yep. Actually, you know what? This March break, why don't we work towards that? Why don't we work towards at least having him here virtually via Zoom?
That would be great.
All right.
We'll love that.
We'll work on that, and I will try and not drop too many F-bombs in front of the boy.
He doesn't hear it 10 times a day from his mother.
Fuck, I know, right?
So, Tara, I got to ask, because the Mighty Micro guy said in the Twitch chat, you need to try Dutch salted licorice, double zoot. Is that, like, what is that?
That's have the thing. They're called droppies. They're called droppies, and they come in salted, double salted for, you know, population control. And they're a thing that's in the Netherlands. But I used to bring them to school, and people thought they were just regular black licorice, kind of like the licorice babies. And so that's right. Sweet licorice, even sweeter than, you know, like black Twizzlers. But people were like, oh, I'll trade you this, like, thing, whatever was popular in 1990, you know, to trade for a school for, you know, your licorice. Okay.
Yeah.
So I give them five of these round medallions that I know they're going to spit out and puke up. And I'm like, meanwhile, I have one of those original fruit roll-ups, which I never got in my lunch. So it was like, well, I warned you. It's a thing. We have some pretty crazy things. It's kind of like the rite of passage when you bring a mouse poop sandwich to school. Chocolate sprinkles on butter. And people are like, what are you eating? And I'm like, it's a mouse poop sandwich. It's like a rite of passage to
wow.
clean people out, apparently.
Oh, wow.
But yes, droppies or droppies are an actual thing. And it's kind of like a test of your will to be able to eat a whole double vaulted drop and not spit it out or puke.
Now, is it called is it called drop? Because that's the sound you make when you're spitting it out. Drop.
No, it's kind of like, because when the machine makes them, it drops like a dollop of it, and then it dries in like the little medallion form, almost like the shape of a small peppermint.
Okay.
I have so much to learn. Tara, thank you for calling. Say hi to the boys for us. We've got to get the boogie break on in 5 minutes, but our friend from South Carolina is hanging on, and I don't want to keep her hanging on too long because she's on her phone, sitting in her car in the parking lot on an international call. Tara, I love you.
Stay safe. Love you guys. Mwah.
Bye, Tara.
Ooh, I got kisses. Kisses. Hello, Ginger, my friend.
Hi. How are you?
I'm sexy as hell. How are you?
I'm also sexy as hell.
Right?
That sounds great.
So you are, this is day number two with you on the show, calling from beautiful South Carolina.
I'm dedicated. I was like, am I really going to call from my car in a parking lot? Am I going to do? Yeah, I am.
Yeah.
Oh, girl, if I had a dollar for every single time somebody just became such a milk maniac because, you know, this is, you know, my animal magnetism. It's international now, kids. There's no stop. I am like the coronavirus of sexiness. That's what I am. In, you know, ain't no border stopping me.
Just drift downward. Down. Terrible. They just come all the way to the south.
All joking and self-serving words aside, how are things in beautiful South Carolina today?
They're good. They're good. I'm driving some lovely lady around, and so that's why I'm in my car. But I wanted to hop in and say hi and also tell you that my show is tonight. And yeah.
Plug away.
Yeah, okay. It's Unmasking Autism, twitch.tv/unmaskingautism. And you can come watch us talk about sensory processing differences with people who are autistic, as well as meltdowns and shutdowns. So all those YouTube videos that you see of autistic kids giving hell in a grocery store, that's called a meltdown. And we're going to talk about those tonight.
Listen, and I'm almost 52, and I there are people around here who would tell you, and maybe people at the Piggly Wiggly down your way who might tell you that they have seen me have a similar temper tantrum.
Yeah, and when you can't get that pink Whitney.
What do you mean you're not going to price match? Ah!
Well, we're gonna talk about why meltdowns are not temper tantrums.
Yep.
So that's very important. That's very, very important.
Yes, and I learned that from one of my friends who has a son who's autistic, where I was like, oh, he's having one of his temper tantrums, and she stopped me in my tracks and said, no. Yeah. It's a meltdown. I was like, okay, now I know.
And that's great. She was advocating for her son. And yep. that is so important. So
yep.
We're definitely gonna get some good facts.
There you go. About
the world. And I am actually still looking for another guest. I have one. I would like to have one more. So if anybody out here is autistic and wants to join the show,
I was just going to ask what qualifications do they need to be a guest on the show? So
just be autistic. oh, my apologies.
No, that's all right. You okay?
Yeah. I'm just dying. It's fine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no big deal. I'm right outside a doctor's office. It'll be great. If you're autistic,
but you're doing it live on the radio now, so I think you can probably declare that as a tax deduction now. It's show promo.
This is quality content right here. If I die on stream, this is fantastic. I couldn't hope for a better death. Anyway, if you're autistic and preferably a way to, I broke John.
Good God.
A way to reliably run Zoom and even just eat earbuds with a microphone would be super helpful. But just DM me on Twitch and we'll get you in there and you can talk about what it means to be autistic and have sensory processing differences and meltdowns and shutdowns.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I'm so glad we've met you. Day two with our friend Ginger from South Carolina, who she's gone. She's back. She's gone. She's back. you'll forgive me for celebrating this, but it's very unusual that a woman shows up in my world 2 days in a row. So, you know,
I'm happy to be that woman.
There you go.
We got to get going for our bigger, better boogie break. Thank you. In your car, too. And by the way, the comment in our chat room right now on Twitch is we here in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada are just a little jealous that you're in your vehicle with, like, just a shirt on. What's the temperature? No. What's a long sleeve shirt, though, so there's that.
Yeah, it is actually, it is, let's see. I'm not sure how to tell. Oh, it is 78 degrees outside, Fahrenheit.
It's apparently 10 Fahrenheit here right now.
Oh, bless.
Yeah, it's a tad bit nipply out there today.
Yep. Yeah. Live from the igloo, the morning brouhaha. Ginger. Thanks for joining us. We hope you have an awesome day.
Yes.
Hope your show goes well tonight. I'm going to make a note to try and tune in. And is your Twitch feed shareable as well? Like, can I host your feed if I'm up and around? I can host your feed.
If you can't now, I'll make it so you can when I get home. And 8 p.m. Eastern Standard, and I hope to see you there.
You are awesome. Hope you'll join us again tomorrow.
Thank you.
It's just not the same without Ginger on the show anymore. Bye, Ginger. There you go. Okay, report does. No, I don't want to. Why does it want me to report people anytime I remove them from our conversation?
Because you should not be removing people.
Well, just let them hang up on their own?
Yeah, just be like, hold on. No, what? You hang up. No, you hang up. No, you hang up.
Hey, Eric.
Hey, John.
You hang up.
Okay, I'll hang up. Thank you, John. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in.
Eric, hang up.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Hang up, Eric. Goodbye, Eric.
Bye.
Bye, Eric. Bye. Goodbye.
Guarantee we bring the brew, ha ha. It's a 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 brew, ha ha. Guess who's playing the brew, ha ha.